Hello again to another 10 minutes coffee break from dSPACE. My name is Norbert Meyer and I would like to appetize dSPACE battery simulation to upgrade your BMS battery management system tests to a new level. As you might already know, ASM is the abbreviation for automotive simulation models. But before telling you something about simulation, let's have a look on existing material. What are the interesting topics in the field of battery controller testing? Let's start with our number one champion, the HIL system. There is various material available in the net which explains and lists all the advantages of our new generation BMS simulator system. Coming to the question of the aimed application area. As motivated in our introduction picture, the domains of our requests are way broader than the automotive industry. Here link to a video which discusses the demands in the electric aircraft domain. By shifting development phases further to front, we want to enable controller tests even prior in time. This leads to SIL testing. By thinking about simulation setups which already provide reasonable test results way before having the code in the final hardware controller. At the end you will find material on automation. Accelerating development, especially in electromobility, yields for an efficient and automated test environment. Please see here a recent blog on this topic. So, from the point of view of a battery simulation library, we can ask the question, how to achieve maximum value for our customers? Sure, we need to prove to be maximum integratable in HIL systems with adequate simulation features, maximum scalable with different domains, maximum flexible to be used in SIL environments, and maximum open for automation use cases. And that's the story of our next minutes. Let's go and start with HIL. dSPACE BMS test systems provide cutting-edge performance for your verification tasks. A modular system from desktop to full size. Voltages of 1500 volts, lowest latencies of microseconds, 300 microvolts accuracy, ISO SPI emulation, and so on. So what does it mean for the simulation model itself? Be as best compatible with this outstanding system as possible by providing all required simulation features. With an ASM battery simulation model, you will receive an open Simulink model, ready to use for real-time simulation, which can be simulated right out of the box, together with parameterization and instrumentation projects, of course. The soft BMS can be used to prepare the model environment, with control tasks for the pre-charged circuit and cell control like SOC estimation and cell balancing, to commission the simulation setup, the test automation, validate the battery parameterization, etc., before connecting to the real BMS system. Next to the controller, we have the plant model. A performant plant model with a cell-wise 2RC circuit equivalent approach to capture diffusion and double layer effects as required, which can also be extended. The model is equipped with a thermal model for a mean temperature or also temperatures of individual stacks. But enough with technical details. Let's have a look if this holds what I'm talking about. We need a reason to believe in this story. Now, jump to Simulink. So we start with the integration of an ASM battery model in a standard BMS I/O model. On the right-hand side, you see a I/O model for a BMS simulator at the very beginning from a project. So we will just copy the ASM parts to the right-hand side and see the easy integration of our modules. So just by extending the bus creator on the right-hand side, let's take 9 ports, extend it to the correct size. So connect these to this one, make it a little bit nicer. And yeah, that's already it. So we will just connect the input ports. And while the model is being updated, so all the signal interfaces are being checked, we will quickly jump to a configuration desk. And I will show you in a multiprocessor setup, which might be also in the case for you. Everything is already prepared in ASM battery. All the interfaces, the inputs, like the relay inputs, the voltages, the temperatures within the battery stack are already available in a pre-compiled ASM battery model by providing the corresponding model ports. Let's have a look inside the Simulink model while it's being updated. So everything is compatible, everything is working right out of the box. Next point, be open for varying domains. Next to the automotive sector, we get requests from power supply, we are in contact with ship manufacturers and even train suppliers, as well as the aviation domain. Let's take the avionic use case as an exemplary domain. In our online BMS material, you will find talks which have been presented in an aerospace symposium. Of course, safety considerations play an important role, especially in aircraft applications. But next to this, the requirements, it is important to be flexible to the individual battery topology, no matter from which domain it is coming from. Let's prove our flexibility. Here is a schematic of our topology nomenclature. Everything needs to be flexible in Simulink, as we know from projects that the architecture of a battery system differs a lot from application to application. CSCs arrangements, mixture of real and simulated CSCs, BMS master-slave architectures, and so on. Everything is possible. Now, jump to Model Desk. So what is possible in Model Desk? So let's jump to the battery itself, the battery pack, and the voltage behavior. Maybe you want to change the parameters of the battery. Maybe you've got, as here, a lithium titanate battery with a lower specific energy and voltage, or maybe you've got another one, like a NMC battery. Everything can be handled in Model Desk itself. Furthermore, if you want to adapt the topology, like the number of stacks in X or Y direction, this can also be adapted in this case. Let's have a brief look into Simulink again. This is an open model, as I said before. You can directly jump into the lowest modeling details and have a look in our implementation, because you might want to understand how we implemented our model. Of course, with a sophisticated documentation, everything is delivered for you to understand our model approach and our interfaces. Having now walked through HRL requirements, let's go to ZIL. ZIL is a universe of application scenarios. Which software parts are available as virtual units, which tests are of interest, and so on. As an illustration, see here an exemplary schematic for BMS. The virtual units are available in different virtual ECU level abstractions connected with each other and connected virtually with a simulated battery model. And how does this look like in a living demo? Now jump to Control Desk and VEOS. So, this is our ZIL demo. Here you see on the left-hand side the connected CSCs, the BMS, and also our model environment, which is connected to the corresponding virtual units. We can just apply here maybe a load current of 1000 amps if you want, and discharge the battery. What you see here as well, we have a reducing SOC on this side of the individual cells, and by using the virtual CAN, you can also see our messages delivered between CSCs and BMS, where these SOCs also correspond to the SOCs, which we see on this layout. The last bullet for a proper BMS test environment is, of course, the automation. So why not taking a proposal for a BMS test catalog, which has been worked out by industry, universities, and inspection institutes like the EU project Everlasting? Put this into our test automation tool in form of a test library, define test cases and KPIs to have an automated test suite. Please note, Automation Desk and our ASM simulation model toolchain are certified in ISO 26262 standard this year to make customers' life easier in terms of processes. This test catalog enables our BMS customer to directly ramp up the ECU test not from zero. Furthermore, it answers the question, is the simulation ready for final automation use cases? Now, jump to Automation Desk. In Automation Desk, we will directly execute a first test. While I'm talking, on the right-hand side, you see our test library, here especially for the BMS tests. On the left-hand side, you see the test suite in the middle, the test sequences as you know it from Automation Desk. The test is already passed. We will open the report. And in here, you will find also the plots for the evaluation of the corresponding model behavior. So there was a switching sequence going on and the voltages behaved as expected. Everything is green. So let's sum up by looking at our initial question. How to achieve maximum value for our customer with a battery simulation product with respect to all the hot topics in this field? By providing Hill Excellence with a plug-and-play ready battery simulation model, which are directly made for closed-loop real-time simulation, including all relevant physical effects. In an open, flexible, domain-independent framework, including soft controllers in a modular fashion to cope with various simulation setups, even in ZIL, as well as in test automation environments with adequate test catalogs proven with an ISO 26262 stamp on our toolchain. This is our approach with ASM Battery to form a product with maximum value for our customers. That's from my side with brief looks in a lot of aspects. Hopefully you enjoyed your break and picked up some interesting news, which might bring you forward. For any questions, requests, comments, just give me a note. Have a nice day. Thanks for watching.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.